Hi, my name's Steve. Welcome aboard my narrowboat home, Moreland Rose. Please join me as I take a slow boat through Britain. Start this vlog at Elland on the Calder Hebble Navigation. Not the most idyllic setting, but handy for the town and refreshment at the Barge and Barrel pub. The first member of my family for you to meet is Nutmeg. She's a Senegal parrot and lives aboard with me. After all, every pirate has to have a parrot. Most mornings start with a little bonding time.
Oh, she does love this.
There are some unusual craft on the canals, particularly the wider ones like the Calder and Hebble. This is a lifeboat from the oil rigs with a stern extension added. Not actually a member of my family, but Cyril the Swan seemed to adopt me during my stay in Elland, but some more of my family members later. Right, time to move on from Elland. I've been here about 4 days and not moving far, only about 5 mile up the canal, if that, either to Sowerby Bridge or to Calder Hebble. Calder Hebble's first. Not sure of what's there. There isn't, doesn't appear to be a lot, but there is a sanitary station. So I'll top up with water there and have a look, see what's there, and possibly then move on to Sowerby Bridge. So hope you'll come along with me. And it's not too bad a day. A bit breezy, but the sun's out and the rain's holding off. So fingers crossed. Let's hope for a nice journey. I'm soon leaving the industry of Elland behind and heading for the countryside of Calder Valley. Thank you. Calder and Hebble joins the Air and Calder Navigation near Wakefield at Fall Ing, 19 miles behind us. A place for a future visit. Ready the lock and then back to bring Moorland Rose in. Such a peaceful setting, so no need to rush. At the bottom of Salter Hebble Locks, the towpath disappears through its own tunnel under the road. It originally allowed the boat horses to move crossing the road. When the road was widened in the 1930s, with no room for the balance beams, the bottom gates were replaced by this guillotine mechanism. Originally requiring numerous turns of the windlass, fortunately the gate is now electronically operated and only needs a CRT key to start the operation. not sure if the line of the canal was altered with the road widening, but this would have been an awkward manoeuvre for the horse boatmen, having to unhitch their horse and then manhandle the boat around this turn. It is just as easy for me to pull Moorland Rose out of the lock with a bare rope than use the engine. Surprising how 17 ton of boat can be moved with very little effort. I have already walked up and got the next lock ready. It is rare that I walk along the roof of the boat, but I had to return to Moreland Road to pick up the handspike. I hadn't spotted that this lock had both types of mechanism at the top gates. It's a sharp right to reach the water point. Whilst I top up with water, I help another two boats through these two locks, and they reciprocate the favour and help me through when I'm done. The bywash is quite fierce at this lock, and I don't make the most graceful entrance. I'm thankful for the help of the other boaters at this lock. It's the shortest on the main system and I need to fit in diagonally. It's really useful to be on board to keep an eye on my position in this lock. Yes, yeah, could well do. Thanks very much. It's a big help, really is. No, I'm the same. Final lock of the Calder and Hebble done, I turn left here. To the right is the short arm of what remains of the Halifax branch. Originally 14 locks raised the canal 100 feet in 1¾ miles up to Halifax, but it was plagued with problems. The local mill owners objected to the canal taking water from the mill stream, and a tunnel was built from the River Hebble here at Salter Hebble to channel the water to a pit near the top lock at Halifax. The pumping station was then required to pump the water 100 feet to the surface to replace that used by the locks. finally completed in 1828 at a cost in today's prices of £6.5 million. It was abandoned in 1942. Well, that's all the lot's done for today. Heading for Sowerby Bridge now. See if I can find somewhere to moor. Have a couple of days, or maybe even a week there. It's nice and handy for my son and daughter in law to get to me. Bring the grandson. And one or two shops about there, apparently, so I've been told. And it's a nice place, just to hide up for a couple of days. That's it, no more locks today.
No, no more locks this holiday. Another 2 weeks and we'll be out back out on the boat.
Oh, go the other way, you've got the deepest lock in the country, haven't you?
Done that.
Oh, yeah. along this section of canal, the towpath has been improved and is known as the Calder Valley Greenway. It forms part of the National Cycle Network, Route 66. Approach Sowerby Bridge, new build properties line the bank. What a great outlook they have onto the canal. I'm not sure why there are two bridge number ones here at Calder Hebble. They are both on the same canal. This is the end of the Calder and Hebble navigation. The Rochdale Canal bears off to port here, but I'm going to carry on straight into the basin and top up the water tank, then turn around and moor a short way past this junction. For watching, a thumbs up would be appreciated, and share the vlog with your friends. It might help get my subscriber count up. Sowerby Bridge is about the closest point to where my son's family lives, and we managed to get out for a pub meal, so come and meet them. Here they are. My daughter-in-law Sally, bringing the latest addition to the family. My son Matt, with the little one, who they are just finding out is about to control their lives. And the star of the show, my grandson Rupert. I'm sure we'll see more of him in future episodes.
But yes, part of the woods is covered, not chickens, but obviously
Bye for now. See you next time when I tackle the system's deepest lock.